But I would say my app script usage at work is relying on things that other scripts that other Googlers have written. And I use one that I find particularly useful, which is to track when people I work closely with are going to be out of office.
Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer Spotlight. Today, joining us in the spotlight is Luis Peralta, Engineering Manager at YouTube. Luis, a warm welcome to you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here. Glad to be talking about out of office today.
Very cool. Before we jump into auto office and what that is and how you've built it, I'm really curious to find out, what do you do in your role as an engineering manager at YouTube?
I think everyone knows what YouTube is these days. There is also a separate app called YouTube Studio for creators. This is where they can manage or understand the performance of their content, manage their community, manage their monetization. And within YouTube Studio, I manage the platform teams, which are a mix of pure infrastructure teams, but also other initiatives with the goal of accelerating product development.
It is, of course, a tool that I know very well, YouTube Studio, which I love using. So thank you to your team to keep on improving this application. And now let's talk about the auto out of office. This is a side project of yours, or it still is, actually. Tell me a little bit about the problem that it solves.
It all started because I had two goals, or one goal and one problem. On one hand, I wanted to learn something outside of work. And on the other hand, basically before going out of office, planning a vacation, one needs to be dealing with a bunch of things like checking into the flights, packing, thinking about the vacation plan, etc. And one still needs to remember every single time to set the out of office message within Gmail, although probably one has already marked the period next week, next 2 weeks as I'm going to be out of office. And auto-declining meetings, etc., and so on. But one needs to remember to do that explicitly. So I thought, okay, given that Google Calendar doesn't do this directly, maybe I can do an add-on so that it does it for me. And this is exactly the problem that Auto OOO tries to solve. Given one's availability in Google Calendar, it will auto-detect if there is an out-of-office block and then enable the autoresponder, and then disable at the end of the period.
I love that explanation of how you wanted to learn something new, but you also wanted to solve a project. So the question is, which technology did you use to create this add-on?
One, it is true that I wanted to learn something new, but I also wanted the thing to work. So I went the easy path, and I really found the Google App Script environment quite easy to use and to get started and getting something working. So the add-on is using the standard Google App Script environment. So the project is built in JavaScript. Over time, I also started relying on some external tooling, so GitHub Codespaces, in order to pull the code using Google Clasp. And then run some linters on GitHub, and I also manage the releasing from GitHub plus Clasp. For the public site that I have hosted under my domain, I am using GoHugo, which is a quite standard static site generator. I tried to keep things as simple as I could.
Sounds good, and I've also seen it, and it looks really good. And not only I have seen this add-on that you've made, because you've made it publicly available on the Google Workspace Marketplace. What were some of your learnings, or maybe, you know, tips that you would share with other creators of such add-ons who want to publish it on the marketplace?
First of all, is prepare yourself to do a lot more of work to get your add-on published for the first time. I think that as an engineer, one tends to think that once the add-on or something is code complete, the job is done. But this is definitely not the case in life in general, but also when developing a Google Workspace add-on. Putting together the assets, the different cards that are going to be shown in the marketplace takes some effort. Writing a good description that conveys the message of what your add-on is trying to solve, etc., also requires effort. And also, Google Workspace Marketplace has an add-on review process that one needs to go through when first publishing the add-on, and all these things require time. So I would say that from getting the add-on to be code complete to getting it live, I would easily say could take 4 more weeks of total time, but of course not work, but just getting the app submitted, then waiting for review, etc. This just takes time. And then in some cases, you will get feedback from the review, so you need to iterate a little bit. So this back and forth and iteration just takes a few more days, I would say. Piece of advice number one is just budget mentally for doing some more work that is unrelated to coding the add-on itself. Once the add-on is live, it's also useful to pay some attention to how it is being used. Is the add-on triggering errors? So here the combination of the tools that Google Apps Script provides plus the Google Cloud Console with its Logs Explorer functionality, I think it's worth paying some attention to that. Something that I also did for Auto Out of Office, again, over time, is also capturing some performance data on how long do some operations take. And I'm also using Cloud SQL to process some of this data and be on top of how the add-on is being used. I would say, lastly, it is quite important for an add-on author to get feedback. And the feedback, of course, it can come from the marketplace reviews, but also having a dedicated form or maybe some link within the add-on so that people can provide feedback can be quite useful. In fact, one of the features that the add-on has, which is the ability to template the autoresponder message based on the description of the out-of-office block. This was suggested by 2 users. I wouldn't say that I would have never thought of it, but feedback is great, so I implemented the feature, meaning at least I have 2 very happy users now.
Those are amazing tips. Thank you so much for that. And plus one, especially for the first that you mentioned, we do sometimes get developers reaching out to us saying, we want to, you know, have a big launch for our new app or our add-on, and we quickly have to publish it on the marketplace. And it's very, very important to factor in some more time for that. It just, it can't be done quickly. So thank you definitely for sharing that with us.
Something I can add here is that I've seen the documentation improve a lot over the last, I would say, 12, 18 months. I remember when I started working on out of office and I was going through the first publication, I did a lot of trial and error, etc. But now there are like a good how to step-by-step guides on how to get this done. And that also make the point of budget some time for this, because code completion is not the last milestone.
That is also something that, you know, we hear what the developers are saying also about the documentation. So we do add these improvements. So a big shout out to the technical writers who maintain this documentation. As you've heard, it's super valuable what you're doing. After all of these learnings you've had, looking back, what are some things that you would do now differently with the knowledge you have or the experience you have?
I did a lot of trial and error and trying to see if some things would work, some things would not. I don't think at this point I would say I would do things very differently, but the reality is that I have acquired a few learnings over the journey of getting out of office out and then iterating on it, etc. So I'm quite satisfied with how things work as of today, but I've already mentioned some of the key points in the journey. So while still relying on Google Apps Script, for example, being able to use some external tooling for LinkedIn, for checking for extra errors, for example. For this, I'm using the GitHub code spaces, but this could also be done in a local environment with the Google Clasp tooling.
What about future plans? Do you want to publish more Workspace add-ons?
That is a great question, because of course this is not my day-to-day job, and the amount of time I have for hobbies is limited, and this is only one of the hobbies, so to say. But yes, definitely. So iterating on out of office is one thing I want to keep doing. Fortunately, the maintenance cost, I would say, at this point is very low, so that is good. Another calendar add-on I thought of, and this is also driven by my own needs as a manager, is that managing my own calendar requires that I invest 1 or 2 hours on a weekly basis, trying to make sense out of it and grouping things so that I can also get some focus time, etc., and so on. But I would like to be able to define a set of criteria or rules that would automatically make events or meeting invitations to be accepted, rejected, or maybe even grouping some of those events based on a set of rules that I could have defined. This is one of the ideas I have that I don't know if I will have time. Definitely the need I do have. And I recently helped my partner, who is a product manager, with the launch of her first workspace add-on, which is called Email Shot, which is basically an easy way to share an email outside of Gmail, either to attach to a Notion page or a Jira ticket or to send over WhatsApp instead of a screenshot. And I was able to move way faster when building and developing that add-on, because I had a bunch of learnings already accumulated from building Auto out of office.
So besides your side projects that you've worked on, I'm also curious to find out if for your day job at YouTube, if you also sometimes use AppScript.
I've used sometimes AppScript to automate some tasks, like let's say I needed to create a bunch of Google Docs based on a template and with some data being filled or extracted from a spreadsheet. For this, I've maybe coded something quick in AppScript, but I would say my AppScript usage at work is relying on things that other scripts that other Googlers have written. And I use one that I find particularly useful, which is to track when people I work closely with are going to be out of office. So I have a specific calendar related to out of offices from people I want to track.
As a matter of fact, I just remember, Luis, that is one of the samples that people can download. I'll be linking it in the description of this video so that anyone could check it out, because our team uses a script that does exactly the same, which is super useful to have an overview of when your teammates are going to be on vacation. So I'm going to add that to the description. And I thank you so much, Luis, for taking your time to talk about your workspace add-on adventures. And I'm looking forward to future add-ons.
Let's see if I have the time. Definitely, I find it very interesting. Thank you for the interview. Thank you for your time.
Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer Spotlight Show. I'm super happy to have us today joining in the spotlight. You know what? I'm going to do that again. I just messed up.